Let us go a step ahead. Consider 4 raised to half, 8 raised to 1 upon 3, 27 raised to 1 upon 3, 16 raised to 1 upon 4. Can you tell which numbers do they represent? No, there is a problem. The index is not an integer but is a rational number. In particular, a rational number with numerator 1. What meaning should we give to 4 raised to half? Let us try to make use of the laws of indices that we know already. We know that a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. Applying it for a is equal to 4 and m, n both equal to half, it will give 4 raised to half into 4 raised to half is equal to 4 raised to half plus half, which is 4 raised to 1, that is 4, or 4 raised to half squared gives 4. Oh, this means that 4 raised to half is a number whose square is 4, which is nothing but 2 square. So, we can say that 4 raised to half squared is equal to 2 square. Hence, 4 raised to half is 2. Similarly, to give meaning to 27 raised to 1 upon 3, let us write 27 raised to 1 upon 3 whole raised to 3 as 27 raised to 1 upon 3 into 3, which is equal to 27 raised to 1 or 27. Hence, 27 raised to 1 upon 3 is a number whose cube is 27, which is 3 into 3 into 3 or 3 cube. Hence, 27 raised to 1 upon 3 is cube root of 27, or we say cube root of 27 equals 27 raised to 1 upon 3 and it equals 3. Now, can you try to find the numbers represented by 8 raised to 1 upon 3 and 16 raised to 1 upon 4? Use the known rules and proceed similarly to get the answers. In general, for a positive number a and a natural number n, we can work similarly using the rule a raised to m whole raised to n is equal to a raised to m into n, and we can write a raised to 1 upon n whole raised to n as a raised to 1 upon n into n, which is a raised to 1 or simply a. Or equivalently, a raised to 1 upon n is a number whose nth power equals a. That is, a raised to 1 upon n is equal to nth root of a. Now, we go a step further. We have already defined rational powers with numerator 1 of a positive number. Let us try to define any positive rational power of a positive number. Let us consider 8 raised to 2 upon 3. What meaning should we give to this? Once again, recall the rule a raised to m whole raised to n is equal to a raised to m into n, and try to apply it. To which power should we raise 8 raised to 2 upon 3? If we raise it to power 3, we obtain 8 raised to 2 upon 3 raised to 3 is equal to 8 raised to 2 upon 3 into 3 is equal to 8 raised to 2, which is 64. As we know that 64 is equal to 4 into 4 into 4, that is 4 cube, we can write 8 raised to 2 upon 3 whole raised to 3 is 4 raised to 3, and hence 8 raised to 2 upon 3 is equal to 4. Let us try one more example. Which number is represented by 9 raised to 3 upon 2? Working similarly, raising 9 raised to 3 upon 2 to power 2, we obtain 9 raised to 3 upon 2 raised to 2 is equal to 9 raised to 3 upon 2 into 2, which is 9 raised to 3, which is equal to 3 into 3 raised to 3, or say 3 square raised to 3, which is 3 raised to 2 into 3, which equals 3 raised to 6, or 3 raised to 3 whole raised to 2. So, we can write 9 raised to 3 upon 2 as 3 raised to 3, which is equal to 27. Very good. Let us generalize this for any positive number A and a positive rational number P upon Q. Can you guess the power to which A raised to P upon Q should now be raised for simplification? If you have understood it properly, you can guess that the power should be Q. Now we write A raised to P upon Q whole raised to Q is equal to A raised to P upon Q into Q, which is equal to A raised to P. Hence, A raised to P upon Q is a number whose Qth power equals A raised to P. That is, A raised to P upon Q is equal to Qth root of A raised to P. Similarly, try to obtain A raised to P upon Q as A raised to 1 upon Q whole raised to P. That is to say that A raised to P upon Q is Pth power of A raised to 1 by Q. Are you getting the essence of all the procedure? We initially defined natural number powers of any positive number, which was simple. We obtained few rules of indices for them. Then, we tried to use the same rules and defined negative integer number powers of positive numbers. Right now, we have extended it to the positive rational number powers.